some may deem not so beautiful, I deem absolutely beautiful. Someone that you idolize, who you've idolized for almost the beginning of time. Like, have you actually consistently idolized someone for the longest time, like since you first saw them in a show or in a music video or something? Have you idolized them since the day you saw them? For me, with Gong Yoo, like, I definitely did. Of course, not just because he's a handsome and astute man, but he's very good at what he does, and it's really inspiring to watch people literally for years and years continue to do what they do. Like, imagine there are actors still to this day who are alive who've been acting since the 60s and 70s, and they're still going. Like, I think that's just absolutely brilliant, because mind you, there are people, right, who worked in the workforce for decades, okay? And especially in construction and stuff, people don't do that for decades, and imagine how taxing that is on the body and the mind. I just think it's amazing for people to continue to do what they're doing for such a long time. It's pretty darn cool. It just goes to show how resilient a human can be, the human body and the human mind, for the longest time. And this is just because of my ignorance. I don't really research people that I enjoy, especially artists. I don't know why I don't invest my time in researching about artists that I like and learning about, you know, what art school they went to, like, just to understand their way of thinking, how they got to where they are now, you know. It's interesting to see the mindset and the habits of people, just to see, like, the difference. I think it's super fascinating. I just think that I need to, you know, involve my time more with researching people that I enjoy, so that I can understand their habits and how they stay consistent and committed to things in their life. Because, to be honest, I'm going on a tangent, I really am. To be honest, I feel like I just don't have enough organization in my life at all. And I would like to learn from people like Gong Yoo and, you know, people who've been in the workforce for decades, and how they stay consistent. I want to understand, how do they stay motivated to do it? And a lot of the times, it's literally just doing it. Like, even if you have no motivation, it doesn't matter. You have to do it, right? Because it's good for your body and your mind. Just checking out information on Gong Yoo, and, like, you know, let me talk a bit about him, because I think he's brilliant. He was born in 1979 in July, so his birthday just passed on the 10th, and he was born in Busan. Have you guys watched the movie Train to Busan? I'm gonna be guilty and say, no, I've never watched it. Sometimes, okay, this is my thing, has this ever happened to you? Here's another tangent. Do you ever start watching something, and then you stop, and then it gets super, super hype, and then you lose interest? Good games, quick games. The day it came out, I started watching the first episode, I'm like, oh damn, this show is gonna be so hype. And then it got so overrated, I just didn't watch it, I didn't finish it at all. So then I migrated over to Alice in Borderlands, and that show, oh my Lanta, check it out, it's on Netflix. Gong Yoo, his actual name is Gong Jichol. He started taking interest in acting in his high school years, which, good choice, my dude. And apparently I'm saying apparently because I could be wrong, like, I don't know, I did do it. was coffee prints. This was in, I think, 2007, 2008. And let me tell you, ever since, mind you, I haven't watched any type of Korean dramas. I don't even know, maybe a year or two. I don't know. My attention span, I just don't have one anymore. I can't sit still enough, long enough to watch a darn show and enjoy it. But when it comes to art, that's a different story. So he was the lead role, and he was able to build a very good reputation in the Korean drama world, and he was able to, you know, show off his prowess and his capabilities and share that with people. And of course, since then, he just, you know, now look at him. Oh, and I totally forgot, he's in Squid Game. You know, anytime I thoroughly enjoy a musician or an artist or an actor or just a prominent figure in society, my foster cat's here. I'm super thankful for them allowing me to experience what they have honed and what they have built themselves. You know what I mean? It's just amazing that they are able to just get out there so that we can now experience their amazing skills and maybe, you know, even kind of integrate that into our own lives. Like I said earlier, learning about how they go about their routines and organization and stay productive, you know. There's also another series called Goblin that he's in, and man, I have not watched it. Because I'm the type of person where, yes, I have no attention span, but also I have to be in a specific mood. Like, I have to feel a certain way to finish something, right? Do you get like that, where it's just not the right time? And yeah, I know some people are saying, well, there's never a right time, you just gotta do it. I get it, but it's a feeling that I go off of that makes me wanna watch it. Just like the other day, there's a book that I read. My mom lent it to me. It's called Midnight Library. It's a book about living multiple lives. And, you know, I had to take my time to read it because every time I read it, I had to be in the right moment, the right mindset. It took me half a year to finish it, and I finished it a couple days ago. And after reading it, I'm like, yeah, I'm really happy that I waited until I was in the right mindset. And mind you, my circumstance is pretty stressful right now. And, you know, given I just had surgery and I have to move and stuff, my living room is a complete mess with boxes. But within that chaos, I was able to find some sense of clarity, and I ended up reading it. So, Gong Yoo was able to really rise gain a lot of recognition for Goblin. It was also known as the show Guardian, the Lonely and Great God. This was in 2016 and 2017. And this show, it got so much popularity, both internationally and, of course, you know, in South Korea. And portrayal of the character, it earned so much praise. Like, he really knew how to get into the character. You know, he became the character. And I think that's really cool and amazing that a person can do that, like, to literally become the character. Like, for example, I don't know if y'all think maybe Jared Leto is a controversial figure, but for the Joker, the way he really got into character, he got pretty wild. Look that up. Same with Adrian Brody in The Pianist. He literally sold all of his belongings and lived out of his car, I forget. And he just totally understood how to live with nothing. And he blew me out of the water with his performance in that movie. Oh my goodness, very emotional. I highly recommend The Pianist. Another nice thing about Gong Yoo is that he is quite the philanthropist, and he's very active when it comes to social contributions. He likes to involve himself in a lot of charitable and social causes, even if you yourself charitable contributions, like 50 cents, a dollar, a little can go a long way, okay? Even a lot of the times when I'm walking, there's quite an unfortunate homeless population here, and it all makes me sad to see, you know? I know it's easier said than done, and I'm looking at this from a very simplistic point of view, but imagine there's so many billionaires in this world. Imagine if the millionaires and billionaires got together and they said, hey, you know what, let's end homelessness. Well, I mean, they probably could. It's a super simplistic way of viewing it, I know. But I hope you understand what I'm saying. So anyway, even when I'm walking down the street and, you know, someone happens to ask me for change or food, I would rather bring them and get them food, or I go and get them food myself. They need to eat. They really need to eat, especially the ones who have animals. You know, a lot of the times, okay, I can't give them food, so I do give them money, but I think any type of charitable contribution you can make, it goes a long way. Good on Gong Yoo for being a part of that type of mentality and mindset. Gong Yoo has been able to maintain, you know, his status as one of South Korea's pretty much most prominent and sought-after actors. He's very, very good at portraying diverse characters, right? So that's something that a lot of people love. A lot of people love to be able to see the true skill of an actor in different roles, right? Of course, it's okay to just stick to one type of personality and, you know, role in your acting career, but I think, in my personal opinion, if you want to soar and really make it somewhere, you've got to be able to really break out of your shell and become somebody else. So he's really good at doing that. One show that I truly love that I watched, I think, last year was Silent Sea. I am a sucker for anything sci-fi, anything that has to do with space. Ironically enough, I'm terrified of open spaces. Like, I have a hard time looking up at the sky because I'm just imagining how big and vast and just humongous everything is beyond the sky, that it really just scares me, right? But I just think it's so beautiful at the same time. I truly, truly loved Silent Sea, and I'm tempted to just watch it again. The actors in it, I absolutely love it. And there's an actor in it who I used to love, the band M Black. Have you guys ever heard of M Black? Like, way back in the day. I think his name is June. He was in it and he did really well. Anyway, it was a really great cast. And, oh man, it was so cool. I really hope that they go on with the second season. Just a